Hi, welcome. Today we are going to learn about the process of obtaining the grant. So before we go to the process, it is important that we know what is a grant of representation and the various types of grants of representation. So a grant or a grant of representation is an order in form of a certificate issued by court which confirms that a particular person is the personal representative or an executor or an administrator of the estate of the deceased or the estate of a dead person or the personal representative of a dead person. So it is an order. A grant is an order in form of a certificate issued by the court which confirms that a particular person is an executor, personal representative or an administrator of a dead person. So in this video, you are going to refer to the dead person as the deceased. Deceased is a better word. So deceased, okay? So there are various types of grants. So there are two types of grants of representation. Number one is the grant of probate. This is where the deceased had a will and he had named the executors. So he had a will and he had named the executor. And this will be issued if there was a will and the will is valid and it was not invalidated. So, and the deceased had named the executor. So you are going to be given a grant of probate. Number two, we have the grant of letters of administration. Under these, there are two types. Number one, there's grant of letters of administration with will annexed. So this one is where the deceased had a will, but he did not name the executors in the will. So there was no executor. Or the deceased had a will and he had named the executors, but the executors renounced their executorship. They renounced their executorship, or they have been cited. There's a video on citation, so go and check that video on citation. So the executors have been cited to take the grant and they have refused or declined to take the grant. So that is when you'll be given a grant of letters of administration with will annexed. Then number two is grant of simple administration. This is where the deceased died totally intestate. There is no will, he did not have a will, or there was a will and it was invalidated. Okay, so you'll be given the grant of simple administration. Okay, yes. So now we go to the process. Now the process from the beginning. So a person close to you has died, and this is the process that it will help you. I hope it will help you. Yes. So number one, sit down as a family, and if the deceased had a will and the executors were not named, or he died totally intestate, he had no will, or the will has been invalidated, you have to sit down as a family and agree who will be the executor where there was a will, or the executors, or who will be the administrator where there was no will. So executors or the administrators, anyone can be the executor or the administrator. Okay, but when you're obtaining the grant, there is the priority. There are people who have the priority right to take out the grant. Like a spouse has priority rights, like the children has priority rights. So there are people who have priority. If there is no spouse or children, a father has priority right. If there is no father, mother, if there is no mother, brother, if there is no brother, sister, you know, all that. So there are person who has superior right to take the grant. So if you have superior rights, or as a family, you can agree either one person to be the administrator or the executor, or two or three or four. The executor or the administrator should not exceed four people. Okay? Four people. But where there is a minor, ensure that at least there is two or more. where there is minus, ensure that there is two or more. So you have agreed on the executors and the administrator. Of course, when the deceased had a will and he had named the executor, you don't need to appoint the executors. Okay? Yes. There are people who don't have the capacity to take out a grant. E.g., a minor can't take out a grant, a person with unsound mind, and a person who is bankrupt. So those are three people who can't, who don't have the capacity to take out a grant. Okay? But any other person can take out a grant. Okay? Who will be the administrator and the executor? Now, obtain an original death certificate. You get an original death certificate because when you are filing, most courts will require you to give them the original death certificate. Go to the chief, number two, go to the chief and get a chief's letter. This letter shows who are the beneficiaries of the estate of the deceased. So after the chief's letter is something we call proof of ownership. You have to bring all the documents that shows that this person, the deceased, is the owner of these properties. If he had properties like land, go to the land registry, conduct a search. Make sure that the search is current, current search. If there's a motor vehicle, copy of the logbook, or a search, you can also conduct a search. If there is share certificate, a copy of the share certificate, bank account, you can put the bank account number. As in, you have to prove to court that this property belonged to the deceased. Okay? You have to prove that this property belonged to the deceased person. And so, when the deceased had a will, some of the documents that you are required to file is number one, an original death certificate. That is a must. There's a will, original will. You have to file an original will and at least two copies of the will. And yes, chief's letter and any other document for proof of ownership. It is the same as what we have done when the deceased did not have a will. Then there are prescribed forms that require to be filled. There are prescribed forms that require to be filled. In case where the deceased had a will and he had named the executor, there are forms that you require to fill. In case where he did not name the executor, there are forms. In case where the deceased died totally intestate or without a will, there are forms. So ensure that you file the right forms to the court. You can either file them yourself or you can go to an advocate to file them or to fill them and file them. And when you're filing or you're filling, there are certain important information that you need to ensure that they're in the document, the name of the deceased, the date of death, the last place known, his residence, the last place of residence. You can also state the relationship of the beneficiaries and the assets, all the assets of the beneficiary, all the properties of the beneficiaries and the liabilities. Ensure that you include all these and you state the value of the estate of the deceased. You have to state the value. Okay, so that you can know which court to go. If the value is below 20 million, you go to the lower court. If it is above 20 million, you go to the high court. So the value is also important. Now, when you have all these documents, now you file them in court. You file them in court and you also be required to pay the court fees and also something we call Kenya Gazette. You'll be required to pay for the Kenya Gazette. So this brings up to the notice. There's a notice that is published to the Kenya Gazette. And this notice must be published for 30 days. So when you file the documents in court, then a notice has to be published in Kenya Gazette about the estate of the deceased so that any person who has an interest in the estate of the deceased and is objecting to the issuance of the grant can make an application to court or can make an objection to court to state why he is objecting to the issuance of the grant. So after 30 days and there is no objection, then you will be issued with a grant. If there will be an objection, then the objection will be heard and the court will make a determination. So the normal process is, if there is no objection, the grant is issued after 30 days. So when the grant is issued, You have to stay for 6 months before the grant is confirmed. The grant cannot be confirmed before the expiration of 6 months. However, if you have an emergency, like you need money for school fees, for hospital, for education, anything, then you can make an application to court for the grant to be confirmed before the expiration of 6 months, and you show that emergency. Yes, if you show an emergency and the court is satisfied that there's an emergency and you need this amount of money, or you need the money, or you need anything, then the court will confirm the grant before the expiration of 6 months. However, the normal process, if you don't have any hurry, if there's no emergency, you have to wait for 6 months for the grant to be confirmed. So after 6 months, you file an application we call summons for confirmation of grant. This application or this summons for confirmation of grant, they show the mode of distribution, how the properties of the deceased are going to be distributed, and to ensure that you have agreed to that mode of distribution. So when you file this application, you have to go to court. All of you, all the beneficiaries has to go to court. You have to go to court. And when you go to court, the court will ask you whether you have agreed to the mode of distribution. If you have not agreed or you are opposing this mode of distribution, then you tell the court you're opposing, and the court will require you to file something we call an affidavit of protest. So you file an affidavit of protest saying why you are disputing this mode of distribution, and you put your own mode of distribution. And the court will hear both parties and will distribute the properties to the mode of distribution that is just and fair. Okay, so when you go to court and there is no an affidavit of, there is no one who is objecting, there is no one who has filed an affidavit of protest, then the court will confirm the grant. The court will confirm the grant. Okay, when the grant is confirmed, now you can transfer the properties of the deceased from the deceased to the administrator, then from the administrator to the beneficiaries. Okay, there are prescribed forms that you fill so they can be transferred from the deceased to the administrator to the beneficiaries. Okay, yes. So that is the process of obtaining a grant from the beginning to the end. And there's a situation where you can find that there are errors in the dates, either names, or you forgot to put a certain parcel of land or certain property of the deceased. So you can make an application for rectification of grant. You can rectify the grant. So you make an application, it will be heard, and the grant will be rectified. Yes. So, and also there's the revocation of grant. This is a whole topic. I'll go into details. I'll do a video on revocation of grants, but the revocation of grant can be made by anyone who has an interest in the estate of the deceased, and maybe you as a beneficiary, you did not consent, or you did not sign, or you are left out in this whole succession, or there's anything fraudulent that has gone in the estate of the deceased. So any person can apply for revocation of grant. That is a not detailed, it is so detailed. So for revocation, I have to do a video on revocation, and I'll do a video on revocation. But any person can make an application for revocation of grant if there's any fraudulent activities, if you are left out as a beneficiary of the estate of the deceased. So any person can make the application. So that is the process of obtaining the grant. I hope that you have learned something, and I hope that it will help you when that time comes. And thank you so much for watching. Kindly subscribe and let me know. Lately, I was feeling like I need a purpose.